tells us a lot this morning as people continue to hold out hope in the community that they will be able to find these four miners alive. John, thanks. Well, just before we heard from the three young people in our special series who have been addicted to prescription drugs, joining me now to talk more about teen drug abuse and what parents can do to prevent their kids from becoming a statistic, Dr. Kent Robertshaw. He's an addiction psychologist. One of the things that really caught my attention, the feds did a big study about this. In this report, they found that 1 in 10 high school seniors admitted to using powerful painkillers, and also 40% of teens and their parents think that abusing prescription painkillers is actually somehow safer than abusing street drugs. Where did we get this mindset and this trend that it seems toward prescription drug abuse? Well, these numbers also when it comes to prescribing these drugs and how doctors are prescribing them. Stimulants, number one, the total number of stimulant prescriptions, Adderall and Ritalin. In our story, we saw the girls crushing this up and snorting it, similar to a cocaine-like high. They increased sevenfold from 1991 are being prescribed. These aren't the illicit ones. These are the ones that are actually being prescribed by doctors. Why are doctors giving these medications out more frequently?
Well, I think there's when there was only a couple of months of life to live. So that's
too disjointed. There's no loop really letting physicians, pharmacists, and patients know how many drugs were being prescribed to a certain individual. 43% of physicians said they didn't ask about any prescription drug abuse problems when taking a patient's history, and a third didn't call or obtain records from the previous physician before prescribing potentially addictive drugs. And you talk about this as well, that there's almost, it's an uncomfortable situation. A doctor doesn't want to make a patient feel uncomfortable when they come to them by saying, hey, are you potentially an addict? But what needs to be done to make sure that people aren't getting these prescriptions that could end up costing them their lives?
Well, I think it reminds me of
faked symptoms to get doctors to prescribe either benzodiazepine, anti-anxiety drugs, or Adderall, which they're then abusing and using as a cocaine-like substance. In the end, what can parents do? What role do parents have in identifying and making sure that their kids don't go down this road?
Well, I think, again,
thanks, Dr. Kent Robertshaw. Great to talk to you this morning. Thank you. We're going to head back out to John in West Virginia.